Aloha and welcome to another Imua on TV episode. This is your first time watching. This is a great resource for you if you're developing a medical product or if you just have an idea for one and you haven't started. So you can also check out our website. It's imua-services.com. That's imua-services.com. There we have more resources for you. We have a podcast. You can find all the episodes of Imua on TV, and I will see you over there. So let's dive into our video today. So you may remember from your upper level business classes or your MBA, those Porter's five forces. So if you haven't had that, then I'll just tell you what that is. And if you have, just think of it as a reminder. So this is a framework designed by Michael Porter, and he's a Harvard Business School professor, and his methods are used in practically every undergraduate and MBA program. So why are they important? Well, they analyze all of the different forces around your product that can kind of pull it in different ways. And today, we're going to be using an example of a medical device and looking at how these apply. So ideally, what I want you to do is look at these how they apply to your idea, your product in development, or if you already have a product on the market, this is really good to just dive into and look at occasionally. So for our example today, we're going to use a shoulder implant. The first force is supplier power. So in this case, usually you'll use a material called, now this is a big word, polyether ether ketone, or PEEK. And that is a polymer used in implants, and it's usually compression molded. So in this case, your supplier is the manufacturer that you go to purchase your PEEK material. Now, if that manufacturer is low on material or something happens to where they can't fulfill your order, then you don't have access to the PEEK needed to make your implant. So that's no bueno. At this point in time, you could be in binding contracts with these suppliers, or maybe the material is very commodity, so the prices can rise and fall. That is a threat to you. And in the past, I've advised clients to always carry extra inventory of their material, have that on hand, because if something happens, you want to be maybe a few months ahead to have that on hand. Just, you don't have to stress about that. And I've even heard that once a plastics company caught on fire and they weren't able to supply any of their clients. So, you know, you're dead in the water at that point if you can't get your material to make your product. So one thing that you can do to avoid this, I always advise to register different suppliers, validate them early, go through that process of looking at their material so you have a few different ones to choose from if something happens like this. That's the very least that you should do, is already have their material validated, have them in your system as a supplier. Now, something extra to do would be maybe you set up contracts where you order half of your material from one supplier and half from another. And I know that's hard to do, especially if you have a low annual volume of product that you're manufacturing, but you know, it can work out in situations like this. So the second force we'll talk about today is buyer power. So with the shoulder implant, you're not selling to patients themselves directly. You're usually selling to a distribution company, or maybe you have your own sales force at this point. So you're selling direct into hospital systems or direct into these networks of clinics. So there is competition in your industry that can impact a buyer decision. You need to keep an eye on the pricing for your product related to the reimbursement. If they're not getting reimbursed very well for your particular product, that's a problem. They're not going to want to buy from you. They're going to want to buy from someone else or go with a different procedure where they are getting reimbursed. So you need to keep an eye on that and keep an eye on what insurance is doing, maybe what the Affordable Care Act is doing. So the third force is competitive rivalry. So in this shoulder implant niche, there's several players and each one has a unique portfolio. So maybe this is your only product, your startup company. This is the first one that you've launched so far. Competitor A has a more diverse orthopedic portfolio. They're into knees, they do hip products as well as the shoulder products. But your competitor B, they choose to specialize in shoulders. They are the person to go to when people think shoulders. They have several different models built for several different things, more of a budget-friendly one that lasts, you know, X amount of years, then a more well-built one that lasts longer, and then they have their premium model that lasts the longest. So after analyzing this, you want to really look at where you fit in. What is your unique selling proposition? How are you standing out from the competition here? And maybe go back and look at opportunities if it makes sense for you to be acquired by one of these competitors. So the fourth one is threat of substitution. New surgical procedures that can minimize demand for your product, these happen all the time. There's surgeons out there pushing the limits on what can be done, just new ways of doing things that are more efficient and better for patient outcomes. And there's also new rehabilitation techniques to heal the shoulder, to protect it from future injury, and to help spur on bone regrowth that was actually, no pun intended, with bone spur. Some people would appreciate my nerdy sense of humor there. But this can prevent surgery altogether. So you need to stay on top of not only the competitors in your particular space, but what is happening in this whole healthcare ecosystem, because that has a big impact. Perhaps insurance companies start limiting the procedures that patients can have, and if they deem an implant is not medically necessary, that's a big deal to you. And at this point, it's up to the patient if they want to elect to do that surgery then. And are they going to pay out of pocket to get your implant? So you need to think about that. So the fifth and final force is the threat of new entry. So there's certainly other shoulder implants on the market in addition to yours, but there's also new technologies coming out all the time. You need to watch out for this, and you need to be aware of the competitors coming into your space. What are they doing? What are these new startups doing? So watch that and learn from it. So now it's your turn. Where does your product fit in when you look at these five forces? Okay, so just to recap, the first force we have supplier power. The second force we have buyer power. The third force is competitive rivalry. The fourth force is threat of substitution. And then that last force is threat of new entry. So do you feel like you want some more guidance? Like, this is just the tip of the iceberg. If you're watching this in November of 2016, I just opened up my program, and that's actually in beta right now, called Invention Idea to Profitable Product. So you can apply for a free spot, and it's free right now because we are in that beta. I'm taking 10 testers to help me shape the program, give me feedback, and then once we relaunch it, you'll be able to take the finished product for free too. So you have one of these founding spots not many people are getting. If you're watching this and it's after November of 2016, hey, that just means you get the finished product. And I'm offering scholarships every year too. So all of this information will still be good. You can go to imua-services.com/IIPP. That stands for Invention Idea to Profitable Product. You can get more information there, or you can text the word invention to 44222 if you're just on your cell phone watching this video. So in this program, what happens, you might ask? Well, you'll learn step by step how to get started in developing your idea into an actual product. You'll get information on how to develop your pitch to investors, get connected to the right investors, as well as development partners that can really make your product a reality from there. So I hope to see you over there. And until the next video, Imua!